I need a noun, guys.
I'm gonna pick Michael Jordan.
Okay, Michael Jordan.
Hi, I'm Shameless Maya, and this is Fast Forward Girls.
If you don't know me, my name is Analia Blass. I just landed in San Francisco. GoldieBlox sent me down here. They gave me this super cool gold suitcase.
We have this little envelope, right?
Pack a bag for the city by the bay, which I did. I'm here, sis. Hi, welcome. Shook. How does data drive storytelling, you ask? Have no fear. You're well on your way. Well, since I'm on my way, I guess I'll find out. That's not very much of a clue, but it might be because, girl, look at this map.
Do you see these? Like, what could this be? What are these glasses?
Hi. What's the deal with the glasses?
That's what's in the box. I guess tomorrow's a new day. I'll find out what the GoldieBlox team has in store for me.
They're taking me to the mystery location. I still have no idea where it is. I guess we'll see.
Hey guys, so GoldieBlox just dropped me off in front of this huge building.
Hey!
Hi, hello!
How are you?
I'm doing good.
I'm Isha.
Hi, I'm Analia.
Nice to meet you. I'm Isha Gupta. I'm a co-founder and head of content at Hooked.
Oh, I know that app. Me and my friends use it all the time.
Oh, that's awesome. Are you ready to see how we build our app and tell stories on it?
Yeah, let's go check it out.
Okay, awesome. Hooked is an app that tells stories in the form of chat conversations and also video, specifically for mobile. Even though we're a very creative app, it's very, very data-driven at the core, and we use science and technology, basically, to determine what we pursue on a creative level. We have 50 million people coming into the app every month reading our stories.
That's so cool.
This is like our little reading nook in the office.
Oh, I love this. I have to take a selfie with you.
Can we
take
one? Let's do it.
How do you use analytics to storytell?
It's a good question. We wanted to see if the gender of the hero of a story matters. Boys actually have no preference. Girls, on the other hand, do have a slight preference. They prefer having a female hero. You can conclude from that it's better to have a female character as the hero.
That's so cool. It really is inspiring to make me want to be the hero of my own story.
You are the hero of your own story. So we threw up some code to show you what the behind the scenes looks like at Hooked.
So everybody here is coders or?
So Ciro's our main coding man. He basically built the app from scratch.
Do you know anything about coding?
I took a high school course. I took a computer science class. So I know like the very basics. I know a little bit about functions, for loops, and if statements, so a little bit.
You're off to a good start.
I have a challenge for you.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yeah, let's go.
All right, let's do it. All right, are you ready for the word challenge?
Yeah, let's get started.
We're taking a piece from one of our chat stories and you have to fill it in with different parts of speech.
Okay.
First word I need is a verb.
Slurping.
Okay, next word is a noun.
My tío Pepe.
All right, and next word is also a noun.
I need a noun, guys.
I'm gonna pick Michael Jordan.
Okay, Michael Jordan.
All right, next word is a verb.
Running out of time.
Sleeping.
All right, and last word is a noun.
Cream.
Cream?
Cream.
Okay. All right. Don't cheat. Don't peek.
Oh, okay.
Don't look. All right. It's time for the big reveal. Ta-da! Here's your story. I'm going to be future Kate and you'll be Kate.
Okay.
I'm slurping you from the year 2039. And I'm you, Kate.
I'm going to block this Tio Pepe.
Wait. I can prove I'm you.
How?
I know something about you no one else knows.
Oh yeah? What's that?
You have a Michael Jordan. You sleeping it up with the cream. And you can't sleep without it.
Love it.
This is a crazy story, but I think we should put your version of this part of the story in the app. What do you think?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right. So let's change out the words to the story.
And
so,
you're just putting in everything straight into the text file?
Into the text file.
Okay.
Just gonna upload this file that we just edited together. Now we're gonna click into the app.
So it's up that fast? Like you just have to scan a code and it just your entire story comes up?
Yeah, well we changed the text file.
Okay.
Uploaded it, rendered in the app, and then we opened it with the code, and now we're gonna see it live.
So that's where all of what I put starts.
Yeah.
I can't believe that it's already on the app. Everything that I put in the app and I'm reading it.
Yeah.
My friends are never gonna believe that I wrote my own hook story.
You can write one anytime for us, so just let me know.
I'll keep you up on that.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
To my home.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Vlada Bortnik. I'm CEO and founder of Marco Polo.
This is where I work. We have 31 employees.
ranging from 3 different countries and 10 different states.
Wow.
I thought I'd show you how Marco Polo works.
Okay.
We bring back face-to-face conversations
mm-hmm.
in a way that's really, really authentic. You just open up Marco Polo.
Okay.
You pick either a person or a group that you want to chat with. So I'm going to pick Megan here. And then you press start. You can say, hey, Megan.
Hello. That's so cool.
I'm here with my friend, Analia. And just showing her how Marco Polo works. And you can tell she's already watching.
Oh.
So that means that when I'm done talking, she can start responding.
So they just come up right here and you can see what they're saying. And
yeah.
She sent a heart.
She sends you a heart, yeah.
Have you coded any of this?
The very first version my husband and I did together.
Okay.
So my background is computer engineering and art.
Mm-hmm.
And that really prepared me for creating a new app. Being an engineer, the thing that I learned the most in school, the thing that's most important is problem solving.
I took the first class that our school has ever provided for our entire high school. We took a computer programming class.
Mm-hmm.
My teacher had never taught it before. He was my math teacher previously, and then he just started teaching computer science. He was teaching us how to program like really early stages. We only know the super basics, but we were coding in Java.
Uh-huh.
And he taught us a little bit
Java
for Python.
Well.
Oh, really? Okay. What parts did you?
Android. Well, actually, when I was a kid, I thought I wanted to be a doctor because my grandparents are doctors.
Mm-hmm.
But I've also always been really interested in technology.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I always like taking things apart and figuring out how things work. And so when my high school offered computer science class, I jumped in. And actually, my teacher was also a math instructor.
Really?
Yeah. And I remember my senior year, when it was time to apply for med schools,
mm-hmm.
I realized that actually, I don't want to be a doctor. I decided to do computer engineering because I really like the idea of learning how the entire computer system works.
Mm-hmm. I think that's just something so many people don't really think about. Like, somebody has to sit down and program these apps.
I definitely think we need to have more women engineers because, you know, we make up 50% of the population, if not more. So we gotta be representing. The beauty of being an engineer is that, like, any idea that you have, you can make it happen. I have a cool challenge for you. Ready for it?
Yes,
all
let's
right,
go.
Pull up a chair. One of the ways we decide what we're going to work on next
mm-hmm.
is we listen to people who use Marco Polo. And every week I get a report of what are the top 10 things that people are asking for.
Mm-hmm.
And the thing that kept coming up, like every week, was something like people kept getting stuck saying Marco Polo is black and white all of a sudden. And we're trying to figure out, okay, what is going on?
Mm-hmm.
And we figured it out that it has to do with filters. People would swipe accidentally and end up in a state like this.
And they wouldn't
know
how to go back.
Exactly.
Okay.
So the challenge is, how would you solve this problem?
Oh, okay.
The idea is like, let's together, because nobody likes working by themselves. So I'll give you the pencil.
Okay.
How I like to start is thinking about what is the actual issue.
So we need to figure out how to make it so instead of getting to the filters by swiping, maybe it's an icon at the bottom that they can choose, and then they can choose filters from there. I know that there's a few like apps here and like things that you can actually touch and do. It can be like an icon down here, and then the user can touch it, and then that's when they can go ahead and choose, okay, this is a filter that I want, rather than just swiping so they don't get stuck in that black and white.
Great. The other thing to think about is like, okay, what are the downsides of this design?
Okay.
Before, people were just able to swipe on a filter,
mm-hmm.
to swipe on the screen to get to a filter.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're introducing a button.
Right.
So what's the downside of that?
How can we tell users if you want a filter, this is the button to choose?
Exactly. So that's definitely one of the downsides.
Mm-hmm.
The other one is that now something that they were doing so easily and fun
is now more difficult.
So every solution will have the
its
positives
downsides.
And
yeah.
the downsides, and we just gotta think through which one. I came up with another idea, and I'll show it to you here.
What do you use those glasses for? GoldieBlox gave me some as a clue.
Oh, no way, that's so funny. They also have a special filter on them to make it easier for me to be working on a computer screen for many hours. It helps with eye strain. Here's a prototype that one of our designers put together. And you can see that what we were really attached to is making it easy for people to use filters as they were recording.
Mm.
We thought that if as you're swiping, we actually showed you the name.
Oh, okay.
Right in the middle, it'd make it easier. But what do you think the problem was with this?
People were still getting confused.
Yes, exactly. And on top of it actually wasn't super easy to implement technically either.
Oh, okay.
We actually end up going with a solution that you proposed.
Oh, okay.
So let me show you what that turned out like. So here's my conversation with Megan. And mm-hmm. we added the button just like you suggested. And we put all the fun things you can do on Marco Polo in one spot. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for spending the day with me.
Such a fun day to spend with you. Thank you for coming over. And before you go, I have something for you. So
okay.
Close your eyes, open your hand. So now open your eyes. I know you like buns.
Oh my God! So, I'm gonna put it on my jacket.
Awesome.
Look, oh my God, yes.
You want me to help you do that?
Yes, please.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, I gotta go
Bye.
Now.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Hi, Analia, it's Maya. How are you?
I'm doing good. How about you?
I'm good. Ooh, love the hair.
Thank you. I love yours.
Thank you. So I am here to help you choose a mentor. I heard you're deciding between two.
Yeah, I'm having a really tough
time.
Tell
me about it.
I just don't know who to pick between the two of them. They're just such amazing
and
women.
What did you come up with? What are you thinking about?
Vlada was so amazing because, you know, she's a coder and she was teaching me about how she created the Marco Polo app and I got to see all of that. But then Esha brought me into the office and got to see the corporation firsthand. And the app, I love it. Me and my friends use it all the time. So I don't know. I'm just really stuck between who I want to mentor me. I don't know, they're just such both amazing people.
Yes, that sounds challenging, but I think one, don't be afraid. And I think you know, and it's just about being brave enough to go with that decision.
You know what? I think I know who I want to mentor.
Yay!
I think I know.
Well, I'm so proud of you and congratulations on everything you've been doing. It's so inspiring to see young women making big moves.
Well, thank you so much.
Okay, we'll talk soon.
Okay.
I need to find out who you
bye,
decide
Maya.
On. Okay, bye.
It's Analia, and I thought about it and I really would love for you to mentor me. If you're down, please let me know. Send me a Marco Polo back. I'd love to ask you questions about coding and have you help me through my journey.
Thank you so much, Lyda. Bye.
Absolutely. I'm so excited. Thank you for picking me, and I'm looking forward to being on this journey with you. Bye.
With this over here, it looks really like sci-fi.
Yeah.
Like looking Star Trek type of thing. Is it like laser tag or something?
It's not laser tag. It's called Music Not Impossible. It's a wearable device. It means that it's a piece of clothing that has technology in it. Do you want to try it on?
Yes. Can I wanna wear this?